Hi guys, Top Hops here, and today is another Reddit day, but we're not going to be reacting to my Reddit, we're going to be reacting to r/FunkoPop. So let's get started. But before we get into that, I did notice that my Reddit was kind of slowing down a bit, and I feel like that's my fault. I haven't been giving you guys some memes. So today, we're going to be taking a couple funny photos that you guys can use as templates. Alright, so let's start with this one here. I know I did get this dog the other day, so I thought it'd be kind of funny. So let's try this right here. Okay, here we go, guys. See what you can do with this. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Okay, now there's the Drake meme where there's like an excited one and then a sad one. So I'm gonna try and do a sad face, then also an excited face. So let's start with the sad one here. And then, hold on. Now, I know those are kind of dumb, but whoever gets the most upvotes on r/TopPops with one of those templates, I'll send you guys a Funko Pop. All right, guys, so let's pull up the laptop here and let's get started with this. I also noticed that they have 145,000 members. We only have 1.4K, but it is a strong community of 1.4K. Anyways, guys, let's get into the first post, which is this right here. My cousin with autism was feeling sad during the quarantine, so I sent him a Funko Pop of his favorite Fortnite skin, and he was so happy. He's a bit camera shy, but he was very happy. Please wish Manuel a happy birthday. Well, Manuel, happy birthday, and it looks like you got a pretty cool Funko Pop. Also, I'm just noticing now, look at all of those gifts. Jeez, there's like four of some. I have never seen that many gifts on a post before. Coming soon to Funko Pop ad icons, this is Fine Dog Entertainment Earth exclusive. This is not part of Virtual Con, so you can pre-order it today. This is a really great pop. I had actually been talking about this one, I think about a week ago, and it's really funny that it's coming out now. I feel like the figure should look a little bit derpier, especially with the eyes, it makes them kind of look a little buggy. But I mean, when they're Funko Pop eyes, they're all black, so it's kind of hard to do that, but it still looks really great. The Child, Walmart exclusive with his most favorite thing in the galaxy, chicken nuggies. Now this post was done by Park Hopping Duo, and this looks really great. I love the way they did that. I also like the way they used the Walmart one because it looks like he's using the Force, so it's probably a lot easier than trying to like manipulate the other one in Photoshop. I guess it does pay off when Funko makes a lot of the same character because they do stuff like this where you can put them into a bunch of different scenarios, such as using the Force on a chicken nuggie. Funko New York Comic Con 2020 reveals Nickelodeon, SpongeBob SquarePants, Barnacle Boy, and Mermaid Man. That doesn't sound right. Usually they say Mermaid Man and Barnacle Boy. That one threw me off there. But these figures do look really great. I remember there was something about one of them coming out for SDCC, but I think it got pushed back due to COVID and everything kind of messing stuff up. So it is really cool they are coming out together. I think, I will say this though, Barnacle Boy should have had pupils because he looks a little bit blank with his stare. I think Mermaid Man looks great, but Barnacle Boy's eyes are kind of throwing me off. But don't get me wrong, guys, I'm still going to be picking up both of them. Oh, also, I know, guys, that I haven't done a video on the New York Comic Con stuff yet, but what I'm going to be doing is showing them all off in one big video so you guys don't have to wait 4 days for them. My custom Pepper Potts rescue from Endgame. This is really well done. Now, I don't know if you used a custom head here or if you just found this off of another figure, but either way, it really does look like her. Aha! I went down to the comments and it said, what head did you use? She said she used Erin Gilbert from Ghostbusters, which would be this one right here. Hold on, let me find it. Yeah, that looks like her. Oh, okay, that's cool. So she painted the hair and maybe different eyebrows, but other than that, it really does look like her. Added the bookcases on the right today. Lexi, this is really well done. Also, guys, I do have a question. I don't know if Lexi's watching, but if she is, that'd be great if she could answer. Or if anybody has cabinets with doors on them, do you guys still get dust on them? Because I feel like you would, but I'm not too sure. Finally got one of my biggest grails off of eBay and one of the most funniest Muppet characters ever. Now, this right here is Swedish Chef. I love the Swedish Chef. I remember, oh, this one really hits home because I remember seeing this one over at HMV when HMV was still open here in Canada, and they had it for $10, and I kept passing by, and I was like, I'm looking for Kermit. I did get Kermit, but then I was like, well, maybe I'll get Miss Piggy or something like that, and I always passed up on the Swedish Chef, and now he's worth, I don't know how much. Let's actually check. All right, so it says on the Pop Price Guide that the Swedish Chef is worth, $175. Oof, I'm sad I skipped on that one. It's still a really cool figure, and I'm glad that you did get one of your grails. But yeah, it's too bad that I did skip on that. And it looked like it shot up to, what was that at? $230 in September. Wow. But an average of like $175, still, that is a lot. So this was posted by Funko McFly, and it says, so this happened, read description. Is there a description? Okay, cool. So it says, early on, I posted about my Billy Mays concept I made. I posted my concepts on my Twitter as well. A couple hours after I posted it on Twitter, I got the attention of none other than Billy Mays III himself, Billy Mays' son. He said he wants to collab with them to bring a pop supporting the Billy Mays charity. Maybe we'll get one soon. Well, Funko McFly, that would be amazing. I would totally purchase one. And yeah, you guys can see there here, that pop ad icon's OxiClean concept, Billy Mays, looks really well done. And you know what, guys? Let's try to make this happen. Everybody go tweet at Funko, let's see a Billy Mays Funko Pop, because I feel like this would be a pretty cool figure going to a great cause. Manga-inspired Great Ape Goku with painted pop protector. Okay, this is neat. So I've never seen anybody ever do something like this before towards the manga. I've seen comic book versions, but this is really neat. And it also said that there was a painted pop protector. Oh, wow. Okay, that is neat. So this is considered the Entertainment Earth Great Ape Goku? Yeah, it was the Entertainment Earth exclusive. Wow, this is really well done. Who did this? Johnny Speed 3. This is some great work right here. This one here says, make sure to always read the description. It says, Funko, a nostalgia-themed bobblehead and vinyl figure company. The line includes Wacky Wobblers and Dorbs. However, these are Funko Pop, fan-made custom replicas. Now, personally, I think this is a little scummy that someone's trying to sell them like this, because you put it at the very bottom of the description and you're selling them for what the real ones are actually going for. So if somebody did buy this, I feel kind of bad, and I hope you can get your money back on this, because this isn't right. Aha, someone else was thinking like I was, guys. It says, I love how they just snuck it right down there in the bottom. Haha, gotta love Mercari sellers sometimes. I agree. You guys really have to read the fine print, and if they don't say anything about it, you should always ask. Mail call, so shiny, now just need the non-metallic ones. Anyone got them? Okay. Why would you start with the metallic ones? I mean, hey, go big or go home, but these look amazing. I am still looking for these figures for a decent price. I saw them over at, where was it? Was it Chrono Toys when we were in California? And they were like $600 or $700 each. Kind of pricey, but I would love to have them in the collection someday. Well, anyways, guys, hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you guys want to see more from me in the future, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, do all that. But this has been an episode of Top Pops. Popsters, thanks for watching. See you guys tomorrow.